Jim Hutchinson at the Fisherman Magazine here on the floor at Icast in St. Croix. You know, you got to travel a long time anymore to find a guy like this, Crazy Alberto.
Oh, stop it.
It's good to see you again.
Likewise, buddy. What's happening?
Nothing. All I know is that every time I see you, we're talking about some new product, and I know that you've got something new from St. Croix to tell us all about.
Oh, my God. There's so many great stuff about St. Croix, but there's one that I am extremely, extremely excited. We have the kayak rod.
Oh, that's sweet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's beyond sweet. Are you kidding me? Now, you kayak, don't you?
A little bit.
Okay. What are the needs? Let's talk about kayaking. What are the needs that you need on a kayak rod?
No matter what I'm fishing for, the most important thing is going to be power.
Exactly. Power is good.
I want a short butt because you can't.
Excuse me? You want what?
Well, I have no butt, but I want a short butt on my rod, a shorter butt because I can't. You need to be able to negotiate.
You want to be able to handle the fish. You want to control them. And absolutely. And in the same token, you know, you just said it. This is what we did. We created this wonderful kayak rod. Now, you see this grip here?
Mm-hmm.
Now, this grip is a very soft grip. And guess what? Just touch it. You can touch it. Biggest thing is when you start catching a lot of fish, and I mean a lot of fish and fish lines and everything else, everything becomes slippery.
Sure.
All right. And you drop the rod, and God forbid, you should drop that rod in the water, and that's done. All right. This actually prevents you from slipping. It has a grip. And at the same token, this part also have a wonderful way you can hold on to the rod much, much better. Now let's talk about strength here. But then we added another feature that we generally don't like to talk about, and basically it is one of the things that we all do. And I admit I am a Googan. And hey, come on. You know, the fact of the matter is the part high sticking.
Sure. It's going to happen when you're on a kayak.
I don't care how good you are, especially on a kayak. The truth of the matter is that fish is going to do a quick turn on you. And what happens?
You're negotiating.
More likely than not, you're going to break the rod.
Sure.
Exactly. Now, let me show you as an example. Do me a favor. Pretend
sure.
you're kayak fishing.
All right. Whoop.
All right. You got a nice
I just fish. Hit the T-top.
All right, now, as you can see, this is a Google maneuver. All right,
I wasn't looking.
All right, now pretend like you're holding the rod. And do me a favor, lift it.
Wait, he's working around the tip. He's working around the tip. Jeez, Al, he's around the tip a little bit.
This is what I'm talking about. This is the strength, and it's so light, and guess what?
It doesn't feel like it should have that much strength. It is so light.
Exactly, and there's six models, okay? Four spinning, two conventional, and the nice thing about it is you have that wonderful St. Croix warranty, which is 5 years, and it's prevented from high sticking. You could actually high stick, not that you really want to. It's, I don't know about idiot proof, Googan proof more or less, but basically that's why this is so exciting. It is literally the Mojo Yak series, and it's coming out in September.
It's good to see you, Al.
Likewise, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Good to
appreciate
see you.
It.